Power. And we have power. All fans are spinning. We have RGB there, and we have... So, we're gonna pre-stage this stuff. Out. And then, I'll let you know, we're going to get all this stuff out of boxes. Wow. Something about this seems off. Because we have, that doesn't seem right. I'm kidding. All right, let's go. CPU in, SSD in, rear brackets. In standoffs. I need to see which standoffs these are. They don't have the book in the box anymore. That's gonna slow me down. These off of this. $1,700 is, it's not these. $1,700 is these guys. In. These are tighten down all the way. The last thing you need is these things being loose. Done, 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 done. Goes off to the side. Now, I'm gonna build the cooler. Go on there like this in the case. So we're going to fan one, fan two. Four screws in, or eight screws in for the radiator. We're gonna set this on the side. We're gonna grab our case now. Take the top panel off. Set that down. Now, one of the things I need to determine very quickly is if I'm gonna have room to install the motherboard with this in there. We're gonna install the motherboard first. So let's go ahead and get this installed. Make sure we don't have any peels back here, no peels on the front. That's part of building a computer correctly, is removing all of the peels. Post standoff in the center. Get our screws out, and it should be these guys. One, two, that's not good. That just rounded out. So, before I go any farther, I'm gonna put these two power cables in, because otherwise it's going to physically be impossible for me to get to. So, CPU. Go back to this management one. That's one. That's the other one. We're gonna use both of them. Rounded out because the actual standoff screwed itself out of the case as I was twisting it. All right, so that's in there. Now let's get this radiator in here. Before we do that, we need to get our screws ready to go with some washers. We're gonna get two. Yeah, that would have probably looked good. For sure. All right. Got a radiator you're putting on the top of the case, you're gonna always 100% of the time use your washers. Two more. All right. Now we lay this down. This is what I was worried about as far as managing these cables. There's only one cable management hole back here. Figure that out here in a second. Let's get that out the way. Get this actually installed. CPU cooler is now attached. I have to figure out where I'm gonna run the management for that though. Because I have all of these cables. And I have to go through a single hole. Though it's not like you're gonna be seeing this because of the way this side panel is. I still wanna do this correctly. Grab some tweezers. Aim for this hole up here that you guys cannot see. It's So if I can grab one of these wires, then I can grab all of these wires. This is the thing that's going to slow me down probably the most, is the cable management. One, two, let's figure out how to get the rest of these wires back here. What did he come up on? We're gonna do it right. Said. And just, I was hoping that this case had more than one management, like little ace, little space, but it does not. So pulling all of these cables through is going to be a nightmare. Well, you know what we're going to do? Even though it's going to slow us down slightly, we are going to remove a fan, which I would generally not recommend. I just didn't realize, this being my first time building in this case, that there was only one cable management hole. Not about to tear cables because I'm trying to go for efficiency here. By removing this fan, it should give me better access to the hole. It's like I said, it's in a weird place. Look how much access I have now. You guys can't see it, but I got access now. That cable. Just going like that, beautiful. And then what we'll do is we'll pull each of these cables to make sure that all of the cable wire that I need for this pulled all the way through. We don't have just stuff just dangling. Thank you. All right, all of our cables are now pulled up. Let's lay this down, get this fan reinstalled. and then continue forward. Larger tip. I always forget this thing is not magnetic. All right, all the way in. These cables needs to go back through. Just this one has to go to the CPU pump slot. Slowing me down quite a bit here. All right, so this cable goes to this slot on the motherboard, and then we move forward with the rest of the build. All right, here we go. Now, memory slots are 2 and 4. Main power cable is going to go through now. PCI Express power. It's gonna come. These are coming from down here. That'll be for our video card. As far as our fans are concerned, so this guy will come here. So we need this cable. Do some of the cables real quick. Or we do the intelligent thing and put all of these, all of the fans are going to spin up at the same time as the CPU. Because if the CPU's getting hot, everything should be getting hot. So that's there. One. Two. This cable is going to go back through. RGB, which goes to this cable, which has to go into the motherboard. We have one, we have two, we have three, and then we will find a slot on the motherboard for you. Where did you go? I know you guys can't see this, but there's no way for me to actually do this and have you guys be able to see it. Where like a camera on like a gimbal would be super nice. Got that under there. Physically, there's more space there. Should be. See the cable. Oh yeah, there's physically no space there, even though it looks like there should be. There is nothing there. No. So close. Here's the cable that I need. Trying to read this real quick. CPU fan, CPU out. So what we're gonna do is we just gotta move this CPU out over one slot to there. And then this going to control all of the fans in the whole case simultaneously. And we do have RGB, an RGB header down below. So that is good. And now what I can do is this cable can be pulled back like that and looks beautiful. All right, let's get the rest of these cables put where they need to go. USB-C will go here, USB-3 will go there as well. So C and 3 both going in there. Audio comes down over here. And then our front buttons let's make sure we're not completely screwing ourselves for cable management. That cable goes that way. So that's an underneath cable. There we go. That's going that way. That's going that way. This will go this way. Actually, no, we'll have this. No, we're going to do that. That, this, and these guys are going to come down. One's going to go there. It's going to be actually a really tight fit. The other one's going to go here. Also going to be a relatively tight fit. And USB 3, USB-C. Let's get this top cable management thing done. Now, next one. We got a little bit of cable management done. Let me give it a quick flip. Problem is this LED cable. You know what? LED cable is going to go into the same slot as our audio. This one's still. Ooh, you know what? That's going to go there. Up so you guys can see it. One. Video card. Let's line this up, see which ones we need to get out. There, okay. Yeah. That's actually a really good deal. Already over half an hour. PCI power. This case has, I remember reading this in the book. That comes off. We have my power supply screws. Here they are. Line this up. It is a bracket that goes on to the power supply. And then the power supply just slides in via that bracket. Power cables. CPU. Make sure these are not twisted, which they would have been. CPU. CPU. Rear power supply. Here we go. First power on. Let's see if we have a post. Power. And we have power. All the fans are spinning. We have RGB there. And we have waiting to see if we got a post. We got a post. Timer. So that was, like around 40 minutes? You probably cut about 10 minutes off of that. Okay, 36 minutes. Not bad. You can probably cut about 10 minutes off of that if I didn't screw up this fan. But everything looks good. Everything's on there. What are our temperatures at? 33? Nice. Let's go ahead and turn on XMP. Fix this cable. Get that cable cleaned up. One. All right, and then we'll pull some of these cables back a wee bit. Pull back. That's pulled back. All right, this cable will want to come up over like so. Customers. I have not built myself a computer in several years. I just do minor upgrades now and again. So, these cables, this got twisted up slightly, so let's correct that. What, Emily? All right. Right. Let's do this cable management quite quickly. Run these cables behind here. Zip ties over here. Oh, I missed a cable. What, Emily? And there we go. There is this entire PC cable managed. Without all that extra Corsair stuff, this is pretty simple. All the cables. Actually, let me put this one in here. Very simple, very straightforward. Not a lot of cables. Decent performance. Yeah, I'm gonna play it after I hit level 100 in Diablo, Emily. I appreciate it, Compound. I'm here just about every single day. Get some photos here of this guy running and some photos of the back of it. Yeah, it is not multiplayer. Just remember that, Emily. absolutely. If you ever have any questions or concerns or comments, just come back. I'll be here. We'll see which one I end up getting, Emily. I'll probably end up spending a little bit on it, seeing as I'm going to play the game for a really, really long time. I did not get that on there correctly. This thing looks so clean. Hey, thanks for watching that video. If you liked that video, make sure you hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And I stream daily on Twitch at twitch.tv/specvengeance. And yeah, if you want to learn more about my services, check out bradentonpcrepair.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.